This is Zodiac, but oh, watch out, sir. Goodness gracious. Welcome back, friends. So we had originally planned to bring you guys a fun video on the science of why whale carcasses explode this week. But as you saw, news just broke that Whole Foods has pulled Maine lobster from its shelves after the delicacy was red-listed by Monterey Bay Aquarium Seafood Watch. If you're new here, I'm KP, a marine biologist who specializes in marine mammals. I have to disclose that I am actually a very staunch supporter of the Monterey Bay Aquarium. In fact, over on my Twitch channel, we hosted a charity event for them that raised about $10,000. Monterey Bay Aquarium does a lot of good work, and they have a lot of interesting conservation programs. One such conservation program is the Seafood Watch. This is a seafood sustainability list. The purpose of the Seafood Watch is to use science-based recommendations to inform consumers and restaurants about whether or not the seafood was harvested in ways that carry a high risk of harming wildlife or the environment. And to leverage that consumer pressure to force the fishing industry into doing more to protect the environment. At the same time, I'm very sympathetic to those that are affected by the losses caused by this kind of a distinction. Being red-listed can result in millions of dollars of lost income. Monterey Bay's Seafood Watch is partnered with some massive suppliers, such as Disney, HelloFresh, and of course, Whole Foods. And the Maine lobster industry is pushing back. Maine lawmakers are introducing a bill to cut federal funding for the Monterey Bay Aquarium. And that's the reason that decisions like this need to be backed by hard science. You are taking away someone's means of putting bread on the table. On the flip side, stripping Monterey Bay Aquarium of their funding would be a huge blow to some of their conservation programs, like their sea otter surrogacy program, which is basically single-handedly responsible for the rise of sea otter populations off the California coast. So why was Maine lobster red-listed? Well, it wasn't just lobster. All seafood caught from vertical lines from pots and traps are now red-listed. And the reason is because of the threat these vertical lines pose to marine mammals, specifically the North Atlantic right whale. North Atlantic right whales are some of the most critically endangered animals in the world. There are less than 340 individuals left in our oceans and only around 100 breeding females. The number of right whales killed or injured by human activities must be limited to less than one per year in order for the population to recover. And the leading cause of death in northern right whales is entanglement in vertical lines used to catch animals like lobsters, crabs, or other crustaceans. The NOAA estimates that there are more than 1 million vertical lines deployed throughout right whale migratory routes, with over 600,000 in US waters alone. And over 85% of all right whales show scars caused by entanglement, and about 100 new scars are detected each year. Even whales who survive these entanglements are negatively affected. A study by the New England Aquarium found that female right whales who survive entanglements had significantly lower birth rates and increased calving intervals. While disentangling these whales can be done, it is extremely difficult and very dangerous. Not only that, but it takes a very specialized team of trained professionals performing under strict permits. Not everyone can do it. As we see in this video, courtesy of Georgia Department of Natural Resources, Florida Fish and Wildlife Commission, and the Sea to Shore Alliance. They're doing this too at like high speeds.
Yeah, the angle was kind of...
This is Zodiac, but oh, watch out, sir. Goodness gracious. Look at the size of this pole, too. This man's holding like a 16-foot pole and just... Oh, so this is like a head entanglement. Oh, this sucks.
He's in. Back up.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, pull me over.
Goodness gracious. Rope could rip your hand off.
Okay, good. Ooh. Now just hold that. Let's hold it, guys. Let's keep
the animal's exhausted.
Pull it. Yeah,
Dragging all this gear, it's part of the problem.
It's in there? Okay.
I saw it lift up a little.
Okay, good. Okay, good.
It should also be noted that the Monterey Bay Aquarium is not acting alone. Their decision is supported by globally recognized conservation programs, such as the Natural Resources Defense Council and the Nonprofit Marine Stewardship Council, who just announced that it is suspending its sustainability certificate for the Gulf Maine lobster fishery. Additionally, last July, a federal court found that the NOAA had broken the law and violated both the Endangered Species Act and the Marine Mammal Protection Act when it failed to do enough to protect these northern right whales from entanglements in vertical fishing lines. But this is where the controversy enters the conversation, because the Maine lobster fisheries feel that they are being accused of a crime without proper evidence. Supporters of the Maine lobster industry will point out that there hasn't been a confirmed entanglement from the lobster fishing gear in Maine since 2004. And the Maine Stewardship Council has acknowledged that there is no direct evidence to show that the fishery is responsible for entanglements of right whales. But that's not necessarily the whole story, as usual. Because when a right whale becomes entangled in lobster or crabbing gear, it is nearly impossible to detect where that gear came from. According to Monterey Bay, more than 90% of entanglements cannot be linked to a specific gear type, and only 12% of the entanglements can be linked to a specific location. And this is in turn corroborated by researchers at the New England Aquarium, who examined over 1,600 entanglement scars. We're only able to trace 16 to a specific fishing gear and location. But a spokesperson for the NOAA told NPR that the agency has documented several large whale entanglement incidents involving Maine lobster gear since the Maine fisheries began marking their gear in purple, which was a new requirement that came into effect in 2020. And given the low number of right whales, documented entanglements are more rare. And as I mentioned, with the population at the level that it is, even one entanglement could spell the end of this entire species and would exceed the potential biological removal level established by the Marine Mammal Protection Act. But this is a really tricky situation because Maine has more than 4,000 people working at lobster fisheries, and Maine itself hauls in about 82% of the US's lobster quota. The state of Maine accounts for half of all lobster landings in the North Atlantic, with a value of around $725 million in 2021. And the Maine lobster industry has taken steps to help protect the right whales, including working with the NOAA and other environmental organizations to develop safer forms of gear and methods, like ropeless traps. There is hope that further improvements to the lobster gear and fishing methods, along with other measures, could reduce the risk of entanglement and restore the fishery's sustainability rating. But in the meantime, what can we do to help the 4,000 people working in the Maine lobster industry? In my opinion, it's the same thing that we do to help farmers in drought years with diminished incomes. In 2021 and 2022, the USDA provided a total of $31 billion to help almost a million farmers, which I also advocated for in my video on the canceled Alaskan snow crab season, which you can find right up here. Many of these families are calling for government relief programs, and I agree, we should absolutely help out Alaskan families that rely on these fisheries. Because these are real people with medical bills, mortgages, rent. Don't forget to like and subscribe, especially if you want to be notified when that exploding whale video goes live. I'll catch you next time. Cheers. Don't forget to like and don't forget to like and subscribe.
Word.
I hate this fucking word now. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Why did it? It was so close. Don't forget to subscribe and like. And the Maine lobster industry has taken steps to help protect the right whales, the lobster whales, which I also advocated for in my video about the canceled Alaskan king crab, not king crab, snow crab, the snow crab. We're only able to trace 16 to a specific fishing gear and location.